Good morning students, welcome to biology class. Last class we discussed and we learned about how the coordination takes place in the animals, okay? And today class we'll discuss how the coordination occurs in plants. In human beings, the coordination is carried by the two ways. One is with the help of the nervous system and the second one is with the help of the endocrine system. Okay, as the nervous system plays a great role in the control and coordination in animals and human beings, why the human beings adapt or develop either the control system? There is an application question for that. So the answer for this is, nervous system shows responses only for the superficial regions, whereas coming to the endocrine system shows a response in the deeper regions. That is the reason the two systems are developed in human beings. But when it's coming to the plants, how the control it will be takes place, how coordination occurs, why the control and coordination is necessary. Is it necessary or not? Yes, obviously it is necessary. If there is no control and coordination in plants, obviously what will happen? The plants, they reach the tops to the skies and they may not grow and they may fall and their leaves may shed down. Okay, and early ripening of the fruits may take place without maturing. So all these disadvantages it will be occur if there is no proper coordinated system in the plants. Okay, so to avoid all these things in plants also they have coordination system. What is that we learn in today's class? Okay, there is a best example for this. We'll start with an example, touch me not plant. Okay, this is also called as a sensitive plant. And in Hindi, we'll call it as a chuhi mugi. Touch me not, sensitive, chuhi mugi, and it belongs to the phylum family that is called as a mimosa. The scientific name for this sensitive plant is Mimosa pudica. Okay, when you observe this Mimosa pudica, touch me not, in Telugu, we'll say it's an attipatti. Whenever you touch, what will happen to that plant means it closes its the pinioles. Okay, yes, let me show this touch me not plant children. Okay, this so if you see this touch me not plant, before touching the plant, see, have a look here. This is an the touch me not plant. Okay, it expands it the leaf blades. This is before touching. When you touch this plant, what is happening here? The leaf blade, it is coming closer. Okay, yes. Why it comes like that? What is happening here? What is the mechanism involved to close its the leaves closer? Okay, yes. See one more picture. With this picture, it is clear for you how this touch me not plant closes its leaves. Okay, yes. If you see, this is the structure of the touch me not plant. We can see the pinnules. Okay, secondary pulvivinus is there, and there is a petiole, and there will be the rachis that is called as a branch. Okay, pulvivinule. This is an intersection. Okay, if you see this particular things, mechanoreceptor cells are present. Actually, what are called as receptor cells in the previous class, I explained. Receptors are nothing but the cells, they are meant for different activities. Okay, here the mechanoreceptors, they will show the responses. That is the reason, and this particular the leaf blade, it will be comes closer. Okay, yes, whenever we touch the leaf, whenever we touch the leaf, what will happen means quickly in response, just the leaf it will becomes closer. Here the stimulus is touch. All the time the stimulus is an external, the response is an internal. Okay, yes, whenever it touches like that, as it's the movement is taking place. Now the question is here, is that movement is because of the growth? No, it's not because of the growth. Okay, when you touch it, the touch me not plant, just the leaf blades, it comes closer. Is it because of the growth? Means it is not because of the growth. Okay, yes, there are certain movements, we already studied those movements. Example, the directional movement of the seedling. Whenever the you kept the seed under the soil, the seed takes the water and it shows certain movements. because of that movement the soil it comes up, and so immediately the shoot it will becomes out, and the radical, that is the root, goes down, and that particular movement is because of the growth. Okay, yes, the touch may not plant, in case of the touch may not plant, the movement is not because of the growth. Okay, yes, whereas coming to the second example, the movement is because of the growth. So with this example, there are two types of movements, we can say that one is dependent on growth, the movement is dependent on growth, and the second one is independent of the growth. Okay, yes, so back to this touch may not plant, what will happen, as you decide, as you learn that the movement is not because of the growth, but how, why the movement is taking place and how this movement it will be occur, what is happening, that we are going to study now. Okay, yes, so whenever the touch may not plant receives the touch, what is happening here means, the first thing we can say that the turgorin chemical it will be releases. Turgidity we'll say, that is the chemical which is present in the water, that chemical it will be, it has to be, comes out in the form of a turgorin, the protein. So whenever this turgorin it will comes, what will happen, this turgorin it will be reaches, it reaches to the pinnules. Okay, it reaches to the pinnules, and then we can say that from the pinnules it goes to the pinnulets. Okay, yes, pinnules means like this. So it reaches to the if this is the leaf is like this, no, so these are all the pinnules, we can say like this, it's there. Okay, yes, whenever there is a touch, obviously what will happen, this the touch, through the touch it will be goes to the pinnules, and this is called as a rachis. So from here it goes to the petiole. Okay, yes, from the petiole then it will be, it starts closes itself the leaf. Okay, yes, whenever this turgorin chemical reaches to the, what is that called as a pinnules, and immediately this, it goes to the pinnae, and then it will goes to the petiole, and from the that petiole what will happen means K plus ions and water it will be exits out. Okay, whenever the water is coming out, the only one thing you have to keep in your mind, children, the plant shows the movement, it depends upon availability of the water. The best example, at our, in your home we'll see every day. Every day if you give water to your plants, the leaf blade it will be expanded and the plant it will be straight. If you don't give the water to the plant, what will happen? There will be the movement in the plant. The plant it will be droops. It drooping up, thus wilting will be takes place and it changes its the shape. Okay, yes. So in plants, of course, there is no nervous system, but the chemical potential actions are also taking place in the plants, and then immediately the loss of the water it will be takes place, along with that it exits K plus ions also. See, here it is, it exits the K plus ions and as well as the water, and so what will happen, it's lost its shape, that makes the leaf to be, it comes closer. Okay, like that it stay maybe the 10 seconds it will be stay, and immediately after the 10 seconds again it gets back its an original structure. So we can say that the movement in the sensitive plant is because of the loss of the water. Actually, what are called the movements? Movements are nothing but, we can also call it as a curvatures, take a turn, okay, or move, okay, or we can also say the tropics. Okay, yes, there is, coming to the tropic movements, there are two types of the tropic movements we can see, curvatures otherwise. There are two types of the curvatures, one is the tropic curvatures, and all the time these tropic curvatures are the directional. See, the curvatures of the two types, first one is what, trophic, and it is a directional, and the second type of curvatures are the nastic and it is a non-directional. Okay, yes, so we have the in your syllabus all the trophic curvatures are given, are there nothing but we can call it as a trophic movements are given in your the syllabus. Okay, whereas coming to the trophic movements, all these trophic movements are directional movements. Okay, yes, we are going to study the five different types of the directional movements. Okay, the first one is phototrophism. The plant bends towards to the light. Okay, wherever there is a light, then the plant, the tendency of the plant is bending towards to the light. Why it is happening, how it will be happening, that we are going to study the later. Okay, second type of tropism is called as a geotropism. Gravity towards to the stimulus, we can say that. The best example for this is when you kept the seedling under the soil, the root move towards to the soil and the shoot grows above the soil. Okay, yes, see here this that is called, we can say that the root exhibits positively geotropism and the shoot exhibits negatively geotropism. That is the second one. Whereas coming to the thigmotropism, the word thigmo explains is the touch. Whenever there is a touch to the plant, for example, when the plant stem is stuck, gets contact with the support, obviously what will happen, that particular side, the growth of the plant, it will be get slows down, and the other sides, the plant growth, it will be actually, it will be participates. Once again, we learn very clearly after completion of these 5 examples. Fourth one is an hydrotrophism. Tendency of the plant is to move towards to the water. That is an hydrotrophism. And the fifth one is a chemotrophism. And the part, it will be the plant parts, it will be moved towards to the chemicals, we'll call it as an chemotrophism, we can say that. Okay, children? Yes. These are all the trophic movements. All these movements are the directional movements. How this directional movements, it will be takes place, that we'll study one after the another. Okay, the first one is a phototrophism. Okay, how you can do this, the phototrophism activity. Here first, to start this phototrophism, and we need cardboard, and we have to remove the cardboard from the one side. Okay, the first one is phototrophism. Photo means light, trophism is movement. And this is, the plant is showing its directional movement towards to the light is called as phototrophism. Okay, yes. Okay. How you can do this particular activity? Yes. What we require for this? We need cardboard. Okay, we need a cardboard, and with the 3 sides only we require this. One side we have to remove it. Okay, and we also need germinating seeds. Yes, that's it. We need a cardboard and germinating seeds and the conical flask and mesh wire. Yes, these are the things it is required for us to start this particular activity. Children, just to take a cardboard. Cardboard, it has in the 4 sides, it has a walls. Usually they will carry the apples or the fruits in the cardboard box, or just they'll take to the longer distance. Take that cardboard and one side just you remove it and just cut it like as a C-shaped structure like this. Okay, yes. So in the diagram just I draw, just you see that cardboard is removed one side and just we made it like as a like this. Okay, now take the conical flask. Take a conical flask and then over the conical flask just to place an mesh wire, and over the mesh wire just keep it as an germinating seeds. So what will happen to these germinating seeds means they will grow after few days. Okay, yes, now setup is ready. We took the cardboard, we removed the one side and just we kept it as an the C corner, and just we took the conical flask filled with the. Okay, children, take a cardboard and remove the one side of the cardboard and just make it like as a three sides, and just you take this conical flask and place this germinating seeds and just keep it all like that, and set this, keep the device near the window, so the sunlight, it will be comes. Now what is happening here, what will happen when you keep like this? So this side where the darker side, this particular region, this is an illuminated side, that particular region is reaches towards to it receives the sunlight, and this particular side it will not resist the sunlight. Okay, in this particular side, the darker side,
the auxins will grow more. Auxins will grow more. Actually, what are these auxins? Auxins are the phytohormones or growth regulators, and we can also call it as an plant hormones. Okay, it is a Greek word and it means increase. Okay, yes, this about the auxins you already studied in the class 9th. I don't know how far you remember that. And when I explained about the meristematic cells and growing tissue, there we discussed about these points. The meristematic region is rapid dividing cells. It has a growing cells, so the growing tissue. Okay, that growing tissue is nothing but it has a chemical called as an auxins. Where these auxins usually they present means they present in the root tip and an shoot tip. Okay, because of this particular the auxin, what will happen? The length of the stem. As you take this conical flask, the length of the stem, what will happen? It increases. Okay, the root it grows. Yes. So the length of the stem it increases. This makes what will happen means whenever the length is increased, obviously the stem it bends towards to the light. And the reason for here, the darker side, more auxins are present. Okay, because of this, what will happen? The length of the elongation of the stem it takes place, and the stem it will be bent towards to the light. So that is the reason we are saying that the plant bends towards to the light. The tendency of the plants while they're growing under the shade, they bend towards to the light. Okay, this activity they ask you to conduct in another way also. Just change the direction of this the root. Root also has auxins, root tips. Okay, if you change the direction of this conical flask, rotate the conical flask in 180 degree centigrade, and the see how this where the root it will be moves and where this the stem it will be moved. Okay, where you have to keep in only the one word. In the darker regions, the auxins growth it will be more. Obviously, what will happen? The plant bend towards to the light. Okay, children, that is about the second the first tropism called as a phototropism. Okay, yes. Next one, the second one is geotropism. Okay, yes. Let's come to this geotropism. Take a potted plant. This okay. This you reverse it. When you reverse like this, we can observe clearly. If you take instead of the potted plant, if you take as what you can call transparent glass, take an disposable glass and take a soil and add a soil in that. And if you keep this germinating seeds, I kept already, but they did not come out. I don't know because of the water, rain, and all. Okay, yes. So if you arrange like this, what will happen? First, this from the seedlings, and we can see the root, the radical, it will becomes up, down. Radical, it will be moved down. Okay, why? Because the root shows positive geotropism. After that, first the shoot only comes out, but shoot move towards to the above surface. Okay, then we can say this is a negative geotropism. Positive geotropism and negative geotropism. That means the root and the shoot. The root and shoot, they're showing the air movements towards to the gravity stimulus. Please keep in your mind, children, root all the time they show positive geotropism, and shoots all the time they shows the negative geotropism. Okay, yes. So the next, the third one is thigmotropism. As coming to the third one, thigmo. What is the meaning of this thigmotropism means? Touch, the movement towards to the touch. Best example for this is pea plant.
Okay. Yes. So whenever you see this pea plant, okay, the pea plant. Other side we can see. These are called tendrils, children. What are they called? Tendrils, or we can also say that they are climbers. Of course, there is a slight difference between tendril and climber. Okay, this side, opposite side again, we'll see the tendril like this. Okay, this is pea plant, children. Okay, let me show the pic for you, then you'll get an idea. Before the pic, I have the original plant with me. See this plant. Okay, see, if you see this particular plant, this is an pea plant, children. One side, see, this is the leaf, and when we are, these are called the tendrils. Okay, these are the leaves and the tendrils. See, when there is a tendril and the leaf this side, alternative side we are not seeing any leaf. Again, another internode. I hope you know that from every innodes the leaves it will be arise. We don't find any leaf in this region. This is called as an internode region. From the node region, the leaf as well as the tendrils are arising here. Okay? Yes. See, this filtered structures we'll call it as an tendrils. In this particular thing we can see very clearly. See, these parts we'll call it as an tendrils. Okay? Yes. So what you are learning about this particular plant means, whenever these tendrils touches with the any either wall or any support or any other stick or anything, what will happen? The tendrils clings to it. Okay, if you see this any stem in this particular region, or the wall, or the any stick, if you see, what will happen means it clings to it. If it is, whenever it clings to its that side, what will happen? The growth, it will be slows down, and on opposite side, the growth, it will be takes place. Okay? Yes. So, this is the best example for thigmotropism. So, let me show the pic. Okay, children, the thigmotropism is nothing but it turns towards to the support, clings towards to the support. Okay? Yes. The best example for this plant tropism is pea plants. So, pea plant tendrils, what happened here? They cling to the stem, or they cling to the stick. That side there is a no growth, or automatically other side the growth it will be takes place. Okay, children, that is about thigmotropism. So the next one is hydrotropism. Hydrotropism, movement towards water, movement towards water is called hydrotropism. Okay, how you can do this means, take a mesh wire or the mesh box and fill with the soil, or we can also say that the sawdust, and just top we can keep one mesh wire. It has the openings and all that. And over this, on corner, just to keep a germinating seeds, okay? And another corner, keep a pot. Keep a pot, and this pot is porous pot. What is the meaning of the porous pot? Means it has an openings like this. Okay, small openings, gaps, porous in nature. Yes. So we are giving only water in the porous pot, children. We are giving water in the porous pot, and this side we are not supplying any water. This is total dry in nature. Okay, as we are giving everyday water, and this particular reason it will be totally it's a wet. When once the germinating sprouted seeds, they start growing, first the shoot come up. This is called as plumule, and the later the root comes, the root grows. So as we are not providing water here, so obviously what will happen means the root take a curvature, the root takes a turn here, the root take a turn and it moves towards to the water. Why? Because in this particular region water is available. Okay, yes, because of this particular movement, what is happening here, why it is attracting towards that, as the root has oxygens, the tips, and they move towards to the water, and then the with this example we can say that the plant, well, the root shows hydrotrophism. Okay, I think this let me show this particular pick ones. The last one is left, that is called as yes, children, see here, we took one the mesh box, we filled with the sawdust, and one corner we ran the porous pot, and another corner we kept the germinating seed, and the root is moving towards to the water body. Okay, children, the last one is left, that is called as an chemotrophism. Chemotrophism is nothing but movement towards chemicals. Chemotrophism. So, towards chemicals. Moving towards chemicals, we'll call it as a chemotrophism. Okay, yes. Children, this diagram we'll also study in how the organisms reproduced also. And let me explain here for this particular activity. Okay, yes, this is okay, structure of the ovary. Inside, we can see this is an embryo sac. These are all antipodals. We'll study very clear in next class. These are the egg cells and synergids. Secondary nucleus, it will be present. Embryo sac is covered by inner integument. This is under will be the outer integument also. Like this, we can see the two layers. This is ovary, children. Okay, and this is style, and this is stigma. Okay, this is full is female structure. Over this female germination of the flower diagram, this is okay. Over this female part, as this is a stigma, over this many pollen grains they will fall. Many, see, many pollen grains will be formed. Actually, what is a pollen grain here? It is a male gamete. This is male gamete. Many pollen grains will be formed, but one pollen grain only form the pollen tube like this. Okay, now where it is moving? The pollen grains are moving towards to the female system. Okay, yes. So this pollen grain forms the pollen grain germinates and it forms the pollen tube. Okay, this is the pollen tube. Like this, it forms the pollen tube. Inside the pollen tube, we can see there will be two male gametes are there. Okay, so what is happening here? These two male gametes are moving towards to the female structure. Inside there are, this is an egg cell, this is a secondary nucleus. One male gamete and egg cell plus male gamete, it will be fuses, and fertilization process it will be takes place. Okay, we don't want to study all these things here, but only learn that pollen is a male gamete, pollen grains are the chemicals, and these chemicals are moving towards to the female system. Okay, yes, so that is about the chemotrophism. So children, I explained today class five trophisms. the trophic movements are, all the trophic movements are directional movements, and we learn the phototrophism, geotrophism, kythigmo, hydro and chemotrophism. All the five tropisms are important for essay questions as well as the short answer questions. Okay, phototropism is important for the essay question children, and just you have to draw the diagrams for all these things. I'll forward the PDF format for the key points and all. At the same time children, I'll give you the homework also. This homework you will write in the 100 pages single rule book, and we'll start the homework from the first lesson. Let me complete the revision, and then we'll start write all the key points in the notebook. Children, that's all for today. Stay safe at home and take care of yourself and prepare well for your class exams. All the best. Thank you.